discuss about one more sequencing mathematic induction going to verify the result. So first you take the question as a B of n. Here 1.3 means a dot represents the multiplication. A dot is what? A multiplication. So 1.3, write 1.3. Instead of multiplication, use the dot. So a dot is a multiplication, it's not a decimal number. Okay, don't confuse that. Now first sequence, substitute put n equal to 1. Put n equal to 1. Then when n equal to 1, n represents the first term. So B of 1. The first term is 1 into 3 equal to 2 into 1 minus 1, 3 power 1 plus 1 plus 3 by 4. So here 2 into minus 1 will come. So 1 into 3 square 9 plus 3 by 4. Finally, it becomes 12 by 4 equal to 3. 1 into 3, 3 will come. So both are equal. So you can write B of 1 is 2. Then you're going to assume. N equal to k, go and substitute, and we assume that B of k is true. After confirm B of 1 is true, then you assume that put n equal to k, then you assume that B of k is true. Now B of k is true, then we can write B of k equal to 1 is to 3, 2 is to 3 square. Plus etcetera k into 3 power k, so 2k minus 1 3 power k plus 1 plus 3 by 4. Next you want to prove that p of k plus 1 is true. How to verify p of k plus 1 is true? Bring the term p of k plus, expand the term until k plus 1. The result should be like that. We have to bring, then we can say that B of k plus 1 is true. If you expand the term like that, then bring the result the same pattern, then you can confirm that B of k plus 1 is true. So you want to bring the term like that. So now we expand the term to B of k plus 1. How to write? We expand until the k term. If we take as a equation 1, then B of k plus 1 equal to 1 is to 3 is to etc. It's a k term. Now we know we have to expand until k plus 1 term. So k plus 1 into 3 power k plus 1. Now from the term 1 to k term, you can replace by the equation 1. Take the term. So 1 is to 3 to k is to 3 power k. Replace by the term here. So you can write 2k minus 1 into 3 power k plus 1 plus 3 by 4. Now the last term, k plus 1 into 3 power k plus 1. Now cross multiply by 4. So 2k minus 1 into 3 power k plus 1 plus 3. Now cross multiply by 4. 4 into k plus 1. 3 power k plus 1 whole divided by 4. Now we can take from here 3 power k plus 1, 3 power k plus 1, take the common. Take the term common from this two term only. So we take 3 power k plus 1. Here 2k minus 1 is remaining. 2k minus 1 plus here 4k plus 1 is remaining. 4k plus 1. Take 3k plus 1 remaining. Here 2k minus 1 plus 4k plus 1. Then at last 3 also is there. The same, take the 3 and write the last. Now multiply 4k inside. So 3k plus 1 and multiply 2k minus 1 plus 4k plus 4 plus 3 by 4. And it becomes a 3k plus 1. 6k plus 3 plus 3 by 4. So minus 1, 4 become a 3. 4k plus 2k become a 6k. From here take 3 common. So 3k plus 1, 3, it become a 2k plus 1. Here multiply only. Plus 3 by 4. So you multiply here, it become a 3k k plus 1 plus 1, we can write like that. The power 1 is there. Now inside, I go into add plus 1 and minus 1. Here plus 1 is there, so along with the term I add plus 1 minus 1. Then 3 whole divided by 4. Now here 1 plus 1, 2 will come, so 2 take common. Then finally it become a, write the term at the beginning. So 2, I take 2 common, here k is remaining. 1 plus 1, 2, that take 2 outside, become 1 will come. The final term minus 1. Then write this power, 3 power k plus 1 plus 1. So 3 power k plus 1 plus 1 plus 3 by 4. So bring the term in the form of 2n minus 1, 3 power n plus 1 by plus 3 by 4. So wherever n is there, we have k plus 1. Instead of n, k plus 1. Instead of n, we have k plus 1. So remaining 3, 4 is there. Then we come to conclusion. P of k plus 1 is 2. So P of k plus 1 is 2. Then write the statement, enter the term P of n. By so 2 by principle of mathematical induction, then P of n is 2 for all n in natural number. So P of n is 2 for all in natural number. At last you write the statement.